आज का जो हमारा लेक्चर है ये जो हमने लास्ट लेक्चर में कंसेप्ट ऑफ रिजॉल्विंग पावर पढ़ा था इसको मैं एक बार रिवाइज करूंगा। तो जब भी हमारे पास किसी एक सिंगल पॉइंट को हम व्यू करते हैं तो उसकी सिंगल पॉइंट की इमेज फॉर्म होती है और इमेज के राउंड अल्टरनेटिव डार्क और जो ब्राइट कंसेंट्रिक सर्कल्स रिंग फॉर्म होते हैं जिनको हम एरीज डिस्क बोलते हैं। तो इसमें ये है मेरे पास एक रिंग है, इसका सेंटर है, ये ब्राइट है, इसके बाद ये डार्क है, उसके बाद फिर से ब्राइट है, उसके बाद फिर से डार्क है। तो ये मेरे पास एक जो पॉइंट था उस पॉइंट के राउंड डार्क एंड ब्राइट फ्रिंजेस सर्कुलर फॉर्म में बन जाती हैं अगर मेरे पास पॉइंट ऑब्जेक्ट है जिसको मैं देख रहा हूं। तो अब इंस्ट्रूमेंट क्या काम करता है? इंस्ट्रूमेंट दो नियरेस्ट ऑब्जेक्ट को सेपरेट देखने की कोशिश करता है। ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट के दो ऑब्जेक्टिव्स होते हैं, वन इज मैग्निफिकेशन एंड अदर इज रिजॉल्विंग पावर। नाउ मैग्निफिकेशन इज हाउ मच एन ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट कैन एनलार्ज ए इमेज, रिजॉल्विंग पावर इज अबिलिटी और कैपेसिटी ऑफ एन ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट टू प्रोड्यूस टू सेपरेट इमेजेस ऑफ टू वेरी क्लोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स इज कॉल्ड रिजॉल्विंग पावर, टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स विच आर वेरी क्लोज। नाउ ऑप्टिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एबिलिटी टू सी देम एज सेपरेट ऑब्जेक्ट्स इज नोन एज रिजॉल्विंग पावर इन क्वालिटेटिव टर्म्स। Now we have to express it in quantitative terms and find out its condition. In case of telescope, telescopes are used to view objects at a very large distance. So distances are less important in this case and angles are more important. And resolving power of a telescope is reciprocal of the smallest angle. It is reciprocal of the smallest angle subtended between two objects which can be seen separately through the telescope measures the resolving power. That angle is called limit of resolution. Reciprocal of that angle is called resolving power. To have a better idea, this is we have got microscope and on the next page, I shall be having telescope. This is telescope. These are the two objects which are lying at a very large distance from the telescope and they make an angle d theta at the eye. This ray makes an angle d theta. Now, there is one diffraction pattern due to the object O1. And the center of that diffraction pattern is P1. And there is another diffraction pattern at P2. This is due to the object O2. Now, if these two objects are resolved, they can be seen as resolved by the optical instrument, then this angle d theta is called limit of resolution. And inverse of this angle, that is 1 by d theta, or reciprocal of this angle, that's 1 by d theta, is called the resolving power of telescope. So next is resolving power of microscope. Microscopes are used to view closer objects. Now two point objects which are closer. In this case distances are very important. So now this will be the reciprocal of minimum distance. In case of telescope, it is the reciprocal of the smallest angle subtended. In case of microscope, we view those objects which are placed near. In this case, distances are more important and we take reciprocal of minimum distance between the two points, which can just be seen as resolved through the microscope. So these are the two objects, distance between them is d, we can enlarge it. So this is the distance d. So we can just see these two objects as resolved. So this is the distance d. this is the distance d between the two objects. Now the condition is that we should be able to just see these objects as resolved. So this is the distance. This is one object O2, this is the other object, and d is the distance between these two objects. Now AB is the lens. Now what is important is we should be able to just see them as separate. Diffraction pattern due to O1 is at P1 and due to O2 is at P2. Now condition for resolution. There is a condition for resolution named as Rayleigh's criteria. Now I will focus on Rayleigh's criteria. What is Rayleigh's criteria? According to Rayleigh, in case of two very close point objects or two very close spectral lines, the pattern may be regarded as resolved if the central maxima of one diffraction pattern just coincides with the first minima due to the other and vice versa. Let us see how. This is the diffraction pattern width of an object A. This has been shown by solid line. This is a solid line. This is the diffraction pattern. And this is the central maxima. Central maxima has got maximum width and maximum height. And this broken line, this is the broken line or dotted line, you can say it. This is the broken line. Broken line gives us the diffraction pattern due to the object B. Now, Rayleigh's criteria is, this is the central maxima due to object A. It coincides with the first minima due to object B. And then this is the first minima due to object A. And this coincides with the diffraction pattern of object B. Coincides with maxima of diffraction pattern of object B. Minima, first minima of object A coincides with central maxima of object B. On the same lines, first minima of object B coincides with the central maxima of diffraction pattern of object A. This is Rayleigh's criteria. तो Rayleigh's criteria क्या कहता है कि जो object A का central maxima है वो coincide करना चाहिए object B के first minima से और object B का central maxima object A के first minima से coincide करना चाहिए. तो ये Rayleigh's criteria है. और इसको अगर हम diagram में दिखाएं तो this is the central maxima of one object और देखिए और ये सेंट्रल मैक्सिमा दूसरी ऑब्जेक्ट के मिनिमा के साथ कोइंसाइड करता है, कर रहा है अभी. तो एक ये हमने एक डायग्राम ड्रॉ की है, इसमें ए और बी, दीज आर द टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स. डिफ्रैक्शन पैटर्न ड्यू टू वन ऑब्जेक्ट इज दिस एंड दिस इज द मैक्सिमा ड्यू टू वन ऑब्जेक्ट. जो ऑब्जेक्ट बी वाला है इसको हमने सॉलिड लाइन से शो किया है और ये इसकी पीक है, मैक्सिमा. मैक्सिमा ऑफ बी कोइंसाइड्स विद फर्स्ट मिनिमा ऑफ ए एंड देन मैक्सिमा ऑफ ए कोइंसाइड्स विद फर्स्ट मिनिमा ऑफ बी. सो दिस इज द बेसिक क्राइटेरिया फॉर रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स और टू स्पेक्ट्रल लाइंस. Now one important thing is we should be able to differentiate between the two utilities of lens. First is magnification and resolution. Superficially if we see, these two things are same, but actually they are different. For example, magnification. Magnification means enlargement of image as compared to its size. Resolution. Resolution is the ability to see to very close objects as separate through an optical instrument. Resolution depends upon minimum spread due to diffraction. Jitna jyada diffraction ke karan spread kam hoga, utni hi image resolved hogi. If the spread due to diffraction is minimum, the lesser the spread due to diffraction, the more will be the resolution of the optical instrument or the object. Magnification depends on focal length of objective and eyepiece. Magnification depends on focal length. Resolution depends on aperture. If the primary images are not resolved properly, then by increasing magnification, we cannot resolve them. Resolution gives more details of the object. And the next important point is resolving power of microscope. Microscopes, they are used to view the objects which lie closer to us. So in these cases, distance is more important. Limit of resolution is the smallest distance between the two point objects so that they can just be seen as resolved by a microscope. Resolving power is reciprocal of the smallest distance between the two point objects such that they can be seen just as resolved through the microscope. Now we have got two objects O1 and O2. Two diffraction pattern due to O1 is P1, due to O2 is P2. Now for resolution, they should satisfy Rayleigh's criteria. Now Rayleigh's criteria is maxima of diffraction pattern due to one object should coincide with the first principle minima of diffraction pattern due to the other object. Now in this case, P1 is the maxima due to object O1. This is the maxima. This is the maxima due to object P1. Maxima of diffraction pattern due to object P1. This coincides with the minima of diffraction pattern due to object P2. On the same line, maxima of diffraction pattern due to object O2 coincides with the minima of diffraction pattern due to object O1. It satisfies Rayleigh's criteria. Now, path difference between these two is 2d sine theta. So the condition in diffraction, the condition for first secondary minimized path difference should be equal to lambda. So this is the condition. Path difference should be equal to lambda. Now path difference, as I have already told you, I am representing it by PD. P stands for path, D stands for difference. So PD is equal to 2 sine theta. So condition for first minima is 2D sine theta should be equal to lambda. In case of diffraction, the condition for minima is that the path difference should be integral multiple of wavelength lambda. For first, it should be equal to lambda. For second minima, path difference should be equal to 2 lambda. For third minima, it should be equal to 3 lambda. In Rayleigh's criteria, we are concerned with first minima. That's why I am writing 2d sine theta is equal to lambda. From here, I shall calculate d. Lambda is equal to 2 sine theta. Now this is limit of resolution. Limit of resolution. Limit of resolution. Now resolving power. Resolving power is equal to 1 by d is equal to 2 mu 2 just sine theta divided by lambda. Mu, in this case I will not consider mu, but in the second case I will consider. Now if the object, this is the expression for air, 2 sine theta, 2 sine theta divided by lambda is expression for air. Now, if the object lies in a medium with refractive index mu, then d is equal to lambda by 2 mu sine theta. Mu is the refractive index of the medium in which microscope is placed. And resolving power, as we know, is 1 by D. So resolving power will come out to be 2 mu sine theta by lambda. For air or vacuum, mu is 1. Now, if we proceed in different manner, reverse manner, for air, mu is equal to 1. Resolving power is equal to 2 sine theta by lambda. Now, 2 mu sine theta, in technical terms, it is called numerical aperture. 2 mu sine theta is numerical aperture. Now, resolving power of telescope. Telescopes are used to view distant objects. So, in this case, it is defined as smallest angular separation. Smallest angular separation, limit of resolution. Smallest angular separation between the two objects which can just be seen as resolved. But in case of resolving power is 1 by that smallest angular separation, 1 by theta or 2 theta. In this case, we are taking d theta. So d theta is the smallest angular separation. And these objects, these two objects, O1 and O2, they can just be seen as resolved. Why? Because the pattern shown in the diagram satisfies Rayleigh's criteria. Now, this solid graph represents diffraction pattern due to object O1. Now, the maxima of diffraction pattern due to object O1, this coincides with the minima of diffraction pattern due to object P2. And on the same lines, maxima of diffraction pattern due to object O2, this is the maxima, this coincides with the minima of diffraction pattern due to object O1. So, Rayleigh's criteria is satisfied and objects are just resolved. Now, in this case, angle d theta is equal to lambda by d. Now, this is the case of rectangular. Eyepiece, but the eyepieces are circular. We deal with circular eyepieces. So, in case of circular eyepieces, we introduce Airy's correction. After Airy's correction, d theta becomes 1.22 lambda divided by d. Now, this is limit of resolution for telescope. So, this is basically, this expression is limit L O of resolution R. This is limit of resolution. Now, resolving power RP for telescope is 1 by d theta. And this is d divided by 1.22 lambda. So, this is the resolving power of a telescope. Now, limit of resolution for I. Limit of resolution for I is 160 degree. We call it 1 minute or 1 minute. 1 minute of an arc is the limit of resolution of normal I. Now, what is point that is to be learned, resolving power of microscope as well as telescope. Resolving power, RP, whether it is telescope or it is microscope, this is always inversely proportional to lambda. And resolving power is directly proportional to aperture. It is directly proportional to aperture. And aperture in case of telescope, aperture is equal to D in case of telescope. And this is equal to 2 mu sin theta in case of microscope. So aperture is equal to 2 mu sin theta in case of microscope. So up to now we have covered resolving power. We are finished with the topic of resolving power. In my next lecture, I shall discuss Doppler effect. And after Doppler effect, we shall be starting with the polarization of light. So this finishes my today's lecture. And before ending this lecture, I will request all of you to kindly view these videos. If you have got some if you don't like it or some comments, then kindly write it. If you don't like it, then please comment so that we can improve. And if you like it, then kindly share it. If you don't like it, then please write the comment so that I can improve it. From language point of view, from diagram point of view, from expression point of view, or from writing point of view, your comments are most welcome. Your comments are the most important entities for me so that I can improve myself and I can serve you in the best possible way. With these words, now I finish this lecture. Thank you very much.